At the St. Louis ARC, we've been really fortunate over the last year to partner with our friends at University of Missouri, Kansas City, and introduce LifeCourse Connect to families all over the state. This is a new opportunity that gives people access to an online platform to store information and plan and problem solve, as well as some other cool features like navigation from the St. Louis ARC's family navigators. But today I want to share with you just a little bit of an overview of what this LifeCourse Online platform looks like so you can take advantage of it. So this is my guy, Fred Bird, and this is what's going to happen when you sign up for LifeCourse Online. If you have more than one person, you're going to come to a home page and it's going to show you that person's picture and their name, say that you are the account manager or just a support person for them, and then it lets you know what's going on. He's got a lot of events happening, he's got some goals going on, and there's two things that he needs some help with. So I need to check in and see if Fred needs support that I can offer, or if I can do some outreach and help him find what he needs. So I'm going to click on Fred Bird. And this is Fred's dashboard. And I think this is really nice. It's such a nice visual for people who receive services and for families, because you're able to see what's happening in a snapshot. Now, unfortunately, Fred doesn't have any activities on his schedule today, but if there was a home game today, that would show up on the calendar. And it would really give him a chance to take an overview of what the day was going to look like and what he should plan for. In the center is a map, and this shows the different places that are important to Fred. We've got Wild Birds Unlimited, Tower Grove Park, where he likes to walk, his house, which is right here, and Busch Stadium, where he goes to work. Now, if you click on all places up at the top, you're going to be able to see what we know about these places. Well, Grandma Bird is right there at Wild Birds Unlimited. So he can go see his grandma if he goes to spot number one way out here. That might be something that Fred likes to do that he needs support with. Number two is his job, and it's got some information about where you would take him if you're providing some transportation. Fred's house, that tells you that he likes to go out to breakfast at Rooster, which is right in front of his house. And then Tower Grove Park. It looks like we could add a little bit more information about what Fred likes to do at the park here. I'm going to go back to the home page, and it looks like Fred is going to need some assistance. He wants to get a massage, and that's coming up on June 30th. If I wanted to help Fred with that, I could raise my hand and say, I'm in, I need a massage too. So just think about that, moms and dads, and Fred. If you want to ask somebody to go with you on an event, all you have to do is let people know, hey, I'm looking for this. And then anyone you've invited to your platform can signal back, can text back and let you know this is what's going on. So I want to go over to Fred Bird's picture and open up this bar on the side and show you what else is on here. This platform is designed to give you a chance to do all of your work using the LifeCourse tools directly here, where you can add information. So usually when people start off, they come down to these resources and start with a vision, so that anybody that's going to get to know Fred can understand over different life domains, what's important to him and what he sees happening in the future. You can fill that out right away, or you can take your time and come back and do that over the course of time. There's a trajectory, which Fred hasn't filled out yet. So there's information we need to add, where we go up to the edit button and we could actually add the information on what does a good life look like for Fred? What are some of the things that need to be in place for him to be happy in his home, his work, his social life? And what are the things he doesn't want? So still plenty of opportunity to do that, but that doesn't mean there's not work that Fred can do along the way. Fred started off by building his LifeCourse team. So he's got the St. Louis ARC helping him out, but also John Mazalek, who's his supervisor, Marianne Tolliver, who's a friend, and Mary Sue Perkey, who's a coworker. All these people are people who can work with Fred. We haven't done the trajectory, but there is a life domain selection. These are the things that Fred said were important for him to start with. He wants to work on his employment and think about safety issues. He really wants to stay in his job, but he'd like to get a raise and he'd like him to retire his jersey over time. So those are conversations he could have with his boss. He wants to maintain his fitness and make sure he stays hydrated because it gets really hot at the ballpark. And then he'd like to spend more time with the T-shirt cannon team outside of work because they're really fun to be with. And he'd like to know more birds like him. So Fred's been able to identify some things that are important in his life. I'm going to go back out to that main area. There's life experiences that you could include. You can do a daily stars for all the things that make you connect and on the job. So this is an employment star. Fred started to write down things that make him really good at his job. And it breaks down all five components of integrated support so that you can see all the different people that might step in and support Fred to have a great life. I'm going to pop this back open. So we've been in the resources area. I want to point out that there's a space here that you can upload documents. So if Fred wanted to include his most recent performance review in here, if Fred wanted to share information from his doctor or from a physical therapist, he could upload that information. And one thing families always ask is, once I include information on here, if I invite my friends in, are they going to be able to see that? And you can only see the information that you've been invited to see. So if I've been added to Fred's team just as a person to help him with an employment goal, I'm only going to see stuff related to that employment goal. So it is very secure. So all those things are under resources. Fred has identified some goals here, and those are both here and over here. You can see Fred's goals. So he wants to schedule a performance review towards the end of the season. And he wants to plan a social event to plan the end of the season. Those are both goals around daily life and employment. Under health, he hasn't added a goal, but Fred said that was important to him. So as account manager, I may need to go in and help him add a new goal. And under social and spirituality, not yet. But safety, he's got a smartphone app to monitor his environment when he's traveling on public transportation. So that's something that Fred's going to want to work on. You can see Fred's goal here, and it breaks it into what we expect to see if Fred's successful, what would exceed our expectations, and then what would minimum success look like? Because we want to celebrate even if there's small pieces that are getting done. So for minimum success, Fred's going to try out 3 or 4 options for different apps, and then he's going to activate that app before traveling at least 6 out of 10 work days each month. So he's going to start getting used to it. Expected success is that he's going to remember to activate that app that he chooses every time he goes out. And then exceeding success is that he's going to do it in all settings, not just work, but also when he's walking in Tower Grove Park and when he's going out to do other social things. Let's see if Fred has any tasks. So we can add tasks in here that we want to include for Fred to do. And then if I want to say a comment, maybe Fred has had a chance to upload a couple apps that he's trying out. He could write down what those apps are so that we'll all know what's happening. So that's a little bit of a sample of the goals. His positive qualities. Again, this is just an opportunity for Fred to share who he is with other people. Values that are important to him, how to support him. This is really an interesting thing. When I got to know Fredberg, I found out that he needs some physical support when moving through tight spaces because he's got peripheral vision problems. So that's important. And says, give him a chance to hog the spotlight. He is a superstar, so he's going to shine. Reminding people to help him get water and drink it, super important, so he stays hydrated. And then sometimes it's hard for Fred to know when it's time to give a hug and kind of making sure that we're helping get positive relationships going. So that's on that platform in the beginning. And again, this is where your supporters are all on the front. So this is just a little bit about all the different components that are in the platform. This breaks down in Fred's settings. He has focused on transition to adulthood. If I was a parent of an eight-year-old, I might want to focus on school age, but I might also want to look at transition to adulthood and hear what those questions are that come up in the platform so that I can prepare ahead for what might be coming. And then it's got the portfolio here and any documents that we want to add. So there's a lot of redundancy in the platform so that you can get to a variety of things from multiple locations. Pretty soon, we're going to have the possibility of sharing videos using the Quillo platform directly through LifeCourse Online so that if there's a really good video about hydration, Fred might want to send that to his team members that help him to get drinks of water at work so they can see why it's really important for him to drink water. So that is our overview of the LifeCourse Online platform today. If you're interested in signing up, you can sign up through the St. Louis ARC and contact one of our family navigators. We'd be happy to help you get signed up on the platform and help you get started using it. And if you want to learn a little bit more, there are many good life groups in Missouri and through the St. Louis ARC where you can come and we'll work through little pieces of this platform every single month so that you can start getting comfortable with the different components. So thank you for joining me today. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you're ready to have your good life. Go out and make it happen.